Okay, so some of you are out there and you're starting to work on the conversion of your text to binary, and you're trying to figure out what exactly we're talking about. You're saying, well, wait a second, I've been taught that computers always use ones and zeros. It's all binary. And you're right. So when we think about that, we come here, and this is one of your large orders table here, this one of the database files we've given you. And it's text, right? This is all text. So it means that in this text editor, I open it up and it's human readable. And that is because this one is not stored as a binary number, but it's encoded as an ASCII character, meaning that it doesn't store 001, it stores some other representation. And that other representation is ASCII, and you probably might remember that from previous courses. So if we look at an ASCII table and find the number 1 right here, it corresponds to the hex value 31. Now, hexadecimal is you know, a 16 base number system, and it takes up each hexadecimal digit takes up four bits, so it takes up a nibble. So a number like 31 is going to take up a byte. So let's take a look at what that might look at. I'm going to pull up a hex editor. I'm going to pull up the same file, and you can see that same one. If you look over here, this is the corresponding ASCII representation of this. So these two are actually displaying the same information in two different ways. This in a text readable form for you and I, and this more in a computer form, right? So this is the 31 we just talked about. There we have it, right? And this is the way it's stored on disk. Well, it's not stored as a 31 exactly. It's stored as a binary version of that. So let's go look. And the reason we use hex is because it's nice, because it's 31 will be a single byte. And that's why we like it. So here we can see this is how it's going to be stored on the disk: 00110001. So that is what physically those bits get flipped on the disk. And you're like, well, great. So what? Why do I care? I mean, who cares how it's stored? The computer displays this text files and I see my one and I'm happy. Well, if I were to store this character not as a character, but as perhaps as an integer, do you recall how many bytes Java integer is? Correct, it is four bytes. So, but this is taking up a single character, a single byte, right? An ASCII character takes up a single byte. Do you remember what a Java character takes up? It takes up two, it's a Unicode character. But, needless to say, coming back here, this is a file that's been converted. Some of the columns have been converted to binary representations. So here we see this is that same one, and it's 00000001, which of course, as you might figure out, is just the binary number 1. It's also the hexadecimal number 1. But you look at that and you're like, well, wait a second, that's great, I've saved it as binary, but how is that an advantage? And in this case, it's not. In this case, saving a single character would be better, right? However, going back to my list here of all these rows, if I go down the rows, obviously at this point I get to three characters, which is going to be three bytes, and then finally I'll get to four characters. And if I keep going, if this is a large file, then eventually I'll get to, you know, numbers like 10,000, and I'm starting to save. So it really depends, right? I mean, if I know that this is always going to be a two-digit number, then maybe I won't save it as an int. Well, of course, I might be able to save it as something else if it's just a two-digit number. Hint, hint. So, you know, the maximum and minimums can help me decide where I want to store things. Now, where am I going to start to get savings that I can see right away? Well, let's take a look at this number right here in text, right? So that, if we go to my hex editor, let's see, can I see where it is? It's right here, right? And how, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 bytes. What if instead of as character data, I tried to store it as an int? Or if you want to try it, you could try it as a float. That might be a little tricky. But if I'm slick, maybe I could store that as an int. And then I'm going to have a big savings on that. So, and if what about this date? Same thing, right? This date is taking up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 bytes. Well, if I could store this as an int, if I could maybe come up with a plan on how to convert that to an int and then just store that, that's only going to take 4 bytes. What about this guy? 5 low. Well, the other thing I can do is look at my data. Is low repeated over and over again? If I look through, I see it a whole bunch of times. And it turns out it's always associated with 5. Okay, well, why am I going to store that data over and over again if 5 always means low, right? So perhaps I could store just the 5. You know, I could either store it as a, I could store it as a char, maybe. Depends on how high that goes, right? Or I could store it as a short, maybe. What I want to do is look at this data and see, you know, see what I can cut out. Like here, clerk. Clerk is the same in every single clerk has that in front of it, right? So why am I going to repeatedly store clerk over and over again? Now, if that's what the form is supposed to be when I print it out, what I do is I can store some portion of the number. And then when I go to print out that column, I can add that back in. But then I don't have all that extra data. So going back to what's the point of all this, let's say I went ahead and I stored everything as well, what does it mean? So let's take a look at maybe a binary file here. The properties of the large orders, it's about 160K right there. If I look at this other version, which is a binary counterpart where some of the columns have been converted, you can see it's smaller. And what this means is that I have to go out to the hard disk fewer times. And that's an expensive trip. You know, basically going to the hard drive is you know, if you look at a trip down to the office as going to the local cache and maybe going to main memory is going to the bursar's office. Going to the hard drive is like going to San Francisco. So each one, and that takes a long time, right, by comparison. So what I want to do is cut down as many of those trips as I can. So even if I haven't saved a lot of space, I've saved potentially a bunch of trips. And therefore, since I have to read this whole file in to do my searches, I'm going to save time. And my searches should be faster. All right, so that's it for this discussion of ASCII versus binary. And if you have other questions, I'll post other videos.